training of our Californian sea lions. So here at the zoo, we have four Californian sea lions. The group is made up of one male and three females. So this our beautiful male, his name is Casper, and Casper's bred a male Barsoo. He's now 7 years old, so he's still very much growing. If you come back in a year's time, he'll be pretty much twice-sided now. He'll weigh an amazing 250 kilos in weight. He's going to be a really large man indeed. He'll be twice the size he is now. And that's because male sea lions always reach twice the size of the females. And if you come here for Belfast, he's learned very different behaviours. And he won't be able to do that when he's very large. Each one of those behaviours has a different signal which he understands. This means that we can use the training to stimulate them both mentally and also physically. Sea lions are very intelligent marine mammals, so we need to just make sure we keep them very active both mentally and also physically. We do this through what's known as an enrichment program for the sea lions. It can be as simple as having fish in their toys, and play their toys in order to get the fish from them. You'll be giving them a hose pipe where they have to lay on their back, so kind of a jet of water in their mouth. It could be as complex as the training if you're seeing us do here today. That physically and mentally keeps them extremely active. And we do three training sessions each and every day, all throughout the winter, no matter what the weather's doing. We're here training the sea lions, even on Christmas Day, which is being the one day that we close that you don't need to do the training. We still do it three times on that day, and this is because they've missed it. Pretty much like your dog, because you miss going out for his walk, you know, why are you actually abandoning me? Why are you not doing that? They really do enjoy the training sessions. It also has a very serious side to it too. He's going to be a really large mammal one day. He will be literally twice the size he is now. We're not going to be able to really train him. So we have to do what's known as teaching him husbandry techniques. And husbandry techniques allow us to examine him all over his body each and every day. Now this little target stick that he just concentrates on, he knows not to move his nose off that target stick. He can pretty much do anything with him. Here's the one point I managed to chip over him accidentally and move to the side stomach, and he still knows that target stick, showing just how good our boy is. So in this position, you can put a little needle in there, we can take a budge off the hind stick, and the best place to take a budge off the G-line box. You can inject it in the hip if you need any antibiotics or any vaccination. We can do all of this without him moving a muscle, and completely focused on that target stick, and not do anything. Until we give him the signal to pick up target stick to me, so he can go back to his station there and get rewarded lots of fish. So it means that we can do lots of different medical procedures, but having to physically restrain him by force. That includes having a look inside his mouth, checking all those teeth are in good working order. Teeth stay black there, that's completely normal for a sea lion. Some of those gums are nice and healthy and pink. That's what we're looking at. There's no signs of swelling or inflammation at all. Now look, Casper's done a fantastic job. We know he's in fine fettle. A male who's in his prime, giving a beautiful waiver off the top of the box. And now he's going to go back down the bottom, and that's where you have the rest of his food. Now we're going to see him in your pen. At the moment, he's got a whole bucket of fish all to himself each day. That's an amazing 9 kilos of fish that he's on. So he does this for a lot of different sea lions here. Costs around £4,000 in money, literally, a year to feed. So they do cost a lot in just herrings alone, of course. It's completely worth it. So that's our beautiful Casper. We've never got a choice of who we're going to bring out next, and it is all made up on the spur at the moment. We have no kind of regime with this, and this means each time we come down here, the sea lions have no idea what they're going to do, because we have simply no clue which one we're going to bring out next, or indeed what behaviours we're going to do. So it makes it nice and fresh and interesting for them. That's why they gallop around, really excited, in their pens, in order to go into the interested as at their feet for training sessions, pretty much like the dog, really excited to go into the car before it goes out on its walk. Never quite know where that car ride is going to be, so very disappointed if it doesn't in fact lead to going down the steps. Now this little girl is Sophia, and Sophia was bred at Rotterdam. She came to us going back now 4 years ago. Under Feisman does the coordinator. They look at all the felines, the breeding collection, and they find the right places for them to go into. And she is a perfect match for our little boy, Casper. Now, since she's been here, she's learned around 30 different behaviours. Each one has different signals which she associates to that behaviour. So all the training we do here is training for what's known as positive reinforcement. Three times she gets it right, she'll get lots of encouragement. And some of the favourite fish just shows exactly the right behaviour there. When she gets it wrong, we don't scream and shout at her. We don't take the fish away. We simply give her a couple of seconds, known as time out. A couple of seconds for her to realise you haven't got to shake the fish back this morning. Must have been the wrong behaviour that I've done. They won't ask her to do it again. And 9 times out of 10, they don't do the behaviour correctly. If we just spend the maybe a medical reason as to why they did it the first time, we'll simply leave it and try again another day. The feline might simply not want to behave, might be a bit bored of doing that each and every day. That's why they instead would choose to do so that you sit there and look at you very blankly. Now this behaviour here is a perfect example of her getting it a little bit wrong. This is now a perfect example of a timeout. And apparently she's been doing this now off and on for a couple of weeks, just getting a bit confused, the wall jump signal, compared to the signal where she goes sliding on her belly like a seal. So she has time to think about it. We're going to go and do the wall jump, aren't we, little girl? Hopefully this time we're going to, yay, go and do the wall jump. So 9 out of 10 times it actually works.